Welcome to Blank Stage Studios, the set of Thrive America. I'm your host, Brent Brooks, and today we're joined by online business consultant, Jason Prance. Jason, let's talk a little bit about what it is that you do.
Sure. My main focus is online business success, I guess you would say. For the last 10 years, I've been launching online businesses, e-commerce, not e-commerce. Some fail, some succeed. And over the last 10 years, it's accumulated to approximately $500 million in online revenue.
Jason, as you know, this is Thrive America, and we've asked you to come to the set today with five specific ways to thrive as it pertains to your field of expertise and your industry. And we're real excited to learn some ways to succeed with our online businesses. So let's begin with your five to thrive.
Well, before we get into that, I've got an interesting story I have to share. It's really quick. I had a client in the past, and she spent about $150,000 on a website that she was absolutely convinced the website was not the problem. And unfortunately, design doesn't matter. Conversion does. And in about 2 weeks later, I was able to produce about $15,000 in actual business for her by making a little $50 website, taking content from her existing site, and just kind of rearranging things and making a call to action that actually got us the account. So,
fantastic. Your first talking point in your five to thrive is identify your pain. Jason, what do you mean by this principle?
The identify your pain is really important because it's very easy to get lost in the muck with everything that you're trying to do. I know so many people that are just finding the next best thing and the next best thing, and oh, I could do this and oh, I could do that, when they don't even get past the first step. You know, find out what your business's problem is, focus on that, and figure out how you're going to solve it. It can get overwhelming. It can get insanely overwhelming. However, if you just write it down on a piece of paper or talk to a colleague and try to get some feedback instead of staying cornered off from the rest of the world, you're going to have a lot more success. There's even a few tools that you can use to help get you there. Mind mapping tools is one thing that I love using personally. And if you just Google mind mapping software, there's some free software, there's some paid software that allows you to brainstorm and put all your ideas on a piece of paper. It's amazing how less overwhelmed you'll feel when you actually put your ideas on a piece of paper and, you know, just sit there and look at it and say, okay, now I know what I'm going to do. And don't be closed-minded. Be open-minded to new ideas, but don't get sidetracked. Focus on what your business needs the most.
The next principle that you talk about is know your competitor.
Yes.
How can we do this online?
If you're a small pet shop owner and you're selling high-end pet products, your competitor is not PetSmart or Petco down the street. They've got a bigger wallet than you do. They've got a larger storefront than you do and way many more customers than you do with other problems that they're dealing with. Focus on online who your competitor is by somebody that's getting around the same traffic that you're doing. That is where you want to start. Your competitor is going to be, hopefully, PetSmart and the larger companies later on down the road, but you want to focus on who's your competitor now. Not only that, but you want to focus on what are they doing to get traffic right now? What keywords are they optimizing for? You can find this out. What the referrals are, where the traffic is coming from. All these things kind of come together when you use some really cool online tools. Most of them are free.
Jason, your third point here is keyword study. What do you mean by this?
What you usually want to start out with it's a large task, and it's hard for people to understand at first. But most everybody knows if they're trying to do an online business, my business would do great if I just was number one on Google for this search term. I mean, if I was just number one for that, I know I'm set. Okay, well, that's a seed keyword, or it's also called a hero keyword. And you could probably come up with at least 5 to 10 of those, and that's good. Come up with 5 to 10 of those, and then once you know that, go use some tools online to try to find even more keywords that you can focus on. Here's why that's important. This will help you identify what the low-hanging fruit is for other keyword terms and even other niche areas of your business that you may not even be aware of. You could be selling a product or offering a service and find out something completely new that you have never really understood before as being something that you could take advantage of. So it's kind of like market research, but you're focusing on what people are actually searching for by the keyword. So once you have a keyword, you can come up with even longer keywords, right? And keywords that are even more focused and more targeted to what you're specifically offering. And guess what? It's easier to rank for those keywords, and you're going to be able to rank a lot quicker. One of my favorite tools is Word Tracker. You can find that at wordtracker.com, and also Keyword Spy, keywordspy.com. They're great tools to be able to just simply plug in your hero keywords or your seed keywords, and out pops tons and tons of other relevant keywords that you can do further analysis on.
It sounds like it's time to test drive our website.
Now that you have actually done all the work as far as keyword study and discovery, it's time to put that good use to action. And this is the exciting part, because this is where you actually start, you know, generating traffic to your site. The quickest way to do that is PPC. PPC stands for pay-per-click marketing. And you probably just want to get started with Google. Google has a product out there you might be familiar with, is called Google AdWords. And it can get expensive if you're not, you know, careful with what you're doing. And you might want to, if ever there's a point in this phase to get a professional involved, now might be the time you want to do it. But at least get your feet wet. Get in there, load up your seed keywords and all the new keywords that you've discovered, and throw a little bit of money at it and try to see what happens. And when you throw a little bit of money at it, you're going to get traffic to your site immediately. As soon as the credit card approves, traffic starts coming to your site, to the landing pages that you tell it to come to. And now you've got some data that you can start analyzing and seeing how well it did for you.
It's very important to convert, and I think this is a problem a lot of people are having. So what do you mean by this?
So now you have some key business decisions to make, and it all boils down to good old-fashioned business decisions to make. But the good news is now you have traffic coming to your site, now you're learning about your customer's behavior, and you're able to you see what happens when people get to your site. But you can't see what happens when they get to your site unless you have a good analytics tool that is working for you on the website. I would have to recommend Google Analytics. It's free, and it's extremely robust. People don't realize how powerful it is. And as a matter of fact, it gets a lot of people a little bit confused with all the things that you can do. But focus on the main things. Where are they coming in at? Where are they dropping off at? How long are they staying? And what are they doing? You know, what pages are getting the most attention on the site? If you use Google Analytics to its best advantage and combine that with Google AdWords on your PPC testing campaigns, you're going to really get a good idea as to the customer's behavior on the site and how to improve upon that. One way to improve upon that is test, test, and more testing. If you have people going to a landing page of your site and you just don't see it doing well and you don't understand why, then make a second landing page, okay? Deliver 50% of your traffic to the one landing page and 50% of your traffic to the other landing page. You would then be able to use Google to figure out what the conversion rate was on each one separately. And then guess what? The winner wins, and you get to use all of your traffic on the landing page that worked better for you.
All right, Jason, great job. Thanks for revealing these principles and ways to thrive. You're officially off the hot seat.
Excellent.
Jason, I ask a similar question to all my guests. You've seen what we're doing here with Thrive America. What is some advice that you could give us to help us take the show to the next level?
Yeah, get on iTunes. I would really love to see, I was surprised I didn't see you guys on a podcast. So if you have an RSS feed URL that is already working on your site, which you probably already do, you submit that URL to Apple iTunes and they review it. You have to go through a little bit of a process of, you know, filling things out and the wait period. But once your podcast is approved, you're set. So every time you do a new show here on Blank Stage, then you're able to syndicate that out to, you know, your own Google almost, you know, which would be iTunes. And guess what? All the marketing's done for you.
Absolutely.
Fantastic. So Jason, if someone watches the show and they're interested in learning more about you, what's the best way to get in touch with you?
Absolutely. You can find me on my domain name, jasonprance.com. That's spelled P-R-A-N-C-E. And from there, you know, I've just got some, you know, ideas, thoughts that run through my head on any other day. And, you know, for anybody that's interested, especially in the step four of the process, getting the PPC ad campaign started, I can do a special offer and provide an amount of time to help get that Google AdWords campaign set up for them, get them started, and see where it goes from there.